This video is sponsored by Tokyotree and Sakurako. So it has been close to 3 months since we had our first initial key visual and preview of the Bleach anime, and because we are reaching that close to 6 to 5 month mark before the anime actually drops, we are going to be seeing a lot more previews in the coming months, and I thought it'd be really cool to just give you a little bit of a rundown as we are in a calm before the storm about really what's just been going on in between and behind the scenes. So first and foremost, as you have seen the key visual, Masashi Kudo did not do this key visual. It was actually Tsuyoshi Kasuno who was in charge of the key visual, and there is a color version out there somewhere. Whether that will be used in the future, we do not know. Whether that will be the main key visual in the future, we'll have to wait and see. But I thought that this key visual was nicely presented, and I'm very excited to see Kudo's version if he does one, and really just see what his designs are going to be following through. But let's talk about production, because everyone is either very worried about it or very excited about it, and I can tell you from my experience, from how I'm perceiving it, is very healthy. But I want to talk about more so on what's being presented to us, not only from the Bleach anime website, but also from a recent weekly Shonen Jump scan, and I believe it has some validity to it. I guess you would say in expressing confidence. So first and foremost, let's talk about the Bleach anime website. The Bleach anime website states and really solidifies the fact that the final series that challenges with talented staff who are just right for the final decisive battle, which is good news. It seems that they've gone out and gotten specifically talented staff. Now, of course, many anime studios are going to do this if they can anyway, but it seems that they really make it very apparent that they have gone out their way to get talented staff, because I don't really think many anime productions or anime websites have really solidified talented staff. It's almost like a reassurance for the fans. But what solidifies this even more is that in the weekly Shonen Jump edition, where it recently talks about the Bleach expedition, there was a part of the segment on that page which states that Bleach is scheduled to start in airing in October, with the cooperation of Mr. Taikubo in the creation of the setting and other aspects. The anime is sure to become a super suitable development. The PV, which caused a huge reaction after it was released, is now available. Now, this tells us one of two things as well, is that yes, they were keeping a heavy eye on how the reaction was for the PV, and they're very stoked about it, and they're very excited the fact of how much of a reaction it got, because I think we can all agree that the fact that it did blow up as much as it did, because I mean it's one of the biggest videos on Aniplex's YouTube channel as well as the Viz Media one too, so that was always cool to really see of how much a reaction that the fans gave it. But to use the word super suitable development again kind of solidifies what the Bleach anime website is kind of telling us with the talented staff. So it is reassuring that again super suitable development means that everything is going just as planned, and that really we have nothing to worry about. So again, maybe a PR stunt, however, I generally believe there is some, you know, validity in this case. But before I talk about the production and go any further into detail, I do want to give a massive shout out to our sponsor for today. Tokyotree and Sakurako have blessed me the opportunity to show you guys this really awesome food subscription service. With Japan still being closed, I imagine a lot of you are missing or would even like to try some really cool Japanese snacks and get a sense of some of the Japanese culture. There are two boxes today of which I highly recommend. First is Tokyotree. In this box, you will get up to 20 of the latest and most exclusive seasonal Japanese snacks, such as Sakura Pepsi and famous variety of Kit Kats, as you can imagine, as well as some little treats you wouldn't even think even existed, like Fanta and even ramen. Sakurako is more of a tea box where you get to experience 20 traditional and authentic Japanese snack items with a nice piece of tableware. But it's also really cool because Sakurako helps with partnering with local Japanese snack makers to share culture and traditions. This month's boxes are in fact Sakura themed, and you'll get to experience so many different snacks you wouldn't even have tried before. For example, and mind the Kit Kats that I have in fact demolished, I also really enjoyed these really cool Sakura donuts. And of course, the Sakura style cookies fitted with a nice bit of green tea. These snacks are limited in Japan, so please don't miss your opportunity to taste these. If you want to enjoy some pop Japanese snacks, you can go choose Tokyotree. But if you want to try something a little bit more traditional, then you can go with Sakurako instead. So, what are you waiting for? If you go and use the code JamesH0322, you can get $5 off your first order of either boxes. That's JamesH0322. So, let's enjoy some Japanese snacks together. So leaving off with talking about the state of production, Taguchi, the famous director that did Akudama Drive, is talking about the fact that he's working completely under the supervision of Taika Kubo, which again is a good or bad thing. You can take it as a bad thing in terms of Kubo is a perfectionist and he may delay things because he just doesn't like something and wants something completely changed. Or you can take it as a good thing, which we will talk about later on. And one of them being extra content, that extra content being in canon filler. One of those in canon fillers is being Uryu and his grandfather. Now, we don't have any specifics on what this actually means and how he's going to really vitalize that within the anime of what we already don't know, but it's interesting to see that Uryu and his grandfather Soken are going to have more screen time and probably a lot more backstory, hopefully more towards what the arrow does, or maybe more towards the history of why Soken survived. Maybe, I'm not quite sure. Again, I like the idea of being left in the dark because it also gives new anime fans as well as old anime fans for Bleach to really experience something new for the first time. And as well, talking about who hurt Rukia at the very start of the Thousand Year Blood War. Now, of course, I already made a video on this. Many people are saying Asken. However, I don't think it was because the transition was a bit different. But again, that's my personal opinion. So to get little things like that, again, is really cool to kind of drive home how, you know, strong these Quincy's are. So I'm really happy that extra content or even more context is being added on to manga panels that maybe not be important, but also could be at the same time. Something as little as Rukia getting attacked could really drive home a sense of fear, in a sense, and that isn't a pun on Asnot, believe it or not. But let's take a little bit of a step back and talk about pre-production. Now, of course, having a big pre-production in terms of time is a really good thing, because again, the longer you take in making sure all the settings and all the details are down means you can execute it better when the production actually starts. And one of these big hurdles of why it also took way too long as well, if you want to classify it as that, is the fact that Masashi Kudo actually explained on his private blog post is that the character sheets, the references of which animators have to go by when animating, especially key animators and in-betweeners, have to kind of use as references, had to be remade from scratch. And that is every single character of Bleach, every single item in Bleach, everything that is a reference in the new manga that hasn't been adaptated, had to be all done from complete scratch. And there is a lot of characters, as you guys know, and a lot of no-name characters as well. So, you know, again, props to Masashi Kudo. He has been working that pen like a god. I almost feel sorry for him in a sense, but at the end of the day, you know, it's good to have a revision of everything in terms of especially new technology as well. And maybe you can add more details than more so than what you probably could in the old anime, right? You know, usually due to thanks to CG or maybe technological advances, right? So again, those hurdles of what you would minimalize in a character design to make it more efficient when adaptating onto a animation is probably a lot less than what it was back in Bleach's original run. And now jumping back into production, we also have Kubo actually say on his club outside as well, we have some really good news in terms of Unohana's Bankai being drawn in motion. And that's what Kubo has been working on this past week or two, which again is really cool as well, because I think a big mystery with Unohana was, what does her Bankai do? You know, how does it work? What are the utilities of it? So I'm really excited to see how that is actually going to be put into motion and how that fight is going to kind of present itself in a sense. Again, if you wanted to be a little bit reachy, you could also say that that's where they are with the anime pre-production right now, while the animators are actually working on the start of the episodes at this current moment, and that's where Kubo is with the storyboarding right now. But again, that's just my theory. We also had some really cool news this week as well, that Takashi Hashimoto is actually returning as either a key animator or an effect animation director. Now, if you don't know who Takashi is, he is a previous effects designer or effects director on many different of the Bleach movies. Like, I think he worked on all of the Bleach movies, including movie 4. Obviously, the ones I'm showing right now are from the Memories of Nobody, which is a little bit older, so don't use that as a representative of what it is now, because he has worked on Dragon Ball Z Broly, and he's also worked on One Piece Film Gold and Jujutsu Kaisen. So, and you guys know how good that those look in modern technology as well. So again, these images aren't representative, but nonetheless, I'm excited because, again, we have another person who is a veteran veteran coming in with mad talent and mad backlog. And every one of his series, if you look on my anime list, every one of his series literally does not miss. Like, he has not worked on a bad show. So I'm very excited to see what he brings to the table in terms of effects. And again, I guess to kind of elaborate on how good the production is that many of the staff also, as Masashi Kudo has also said in his private blog post, is that many of the few staff or Kudo has been working on other projects as well. And that to me, yes, while I would like all the attention to be on Bleach right now, you have to remember that coming by with animators or coming by with directors is hard to come by, especially as the anime industry is growing right now. There's probably a lot of shows or a lot of IPs with contracts that haven't ended for other shows. So like Kudo, for example, could still be working on illustrations for other shows or maybe other games that he hasn't contractually like finished his obligation yet, if that makes sense. But why is this a good thing? Well, the fact that Taguchi has also said that he's not in a rush, which is good, he's taking his time, but also the fact that, like, Kudo has kind of already expressed how, like, good the, well, he hasn't expressed, but he's kind of alluded on how good the production time is at the moment, and the fact that he gets to work on other series as well as Bleach and not stress, or not show any signs of stress through working on Bleach goes to show to me that he has a good production time and a good production schedule too, because it makes sure that even if it's just him or even other animators involved, like, there has been no indication anywhere to me personally where I've seen any signs of stress or rushing work or meeting deadlines so far. So as it stands, as of right now, everything seems to go pretty healthily right now, and I'm very excited about that in general. But with the production all out the way right now, let's talk a little bit about business and marketing as well as future plans for Bleach. Now, it's been really cool to see a really big boom in Bleach merchandise as of recently. That goes to Ichigo figures or even Burn the Witch figures in general. There have been a very big influx. I think recently there was an Orihime one and also recently a Soifon one, which again, we're getting more Bleach figures than what we really had throughout all of Bleach's entire run in general. I think we're getting close to it, if not at the least. So I'm really glad to see that there is a lot of investment going into Bleach merchandise, and especially as well, let's talk about the Bleach Expo success in general. Bleach Expo was originally supposed to run in Tokyo and Tokyo only, but due to its success, it also reached out to Osaka as well, and I think that starts on the 24th of March. And why this is important too, because not only are people paying tickets and reserving tickets to go to this exhibit, you're also seeing the merchandise completely sell out. Like, if you follow the Bleach Exposition Twitter page, you will see countless tweets where they keep stressing that all their merchandise keeps running out and they can't supply it quick enough. So that again is a massive deal and goes to show just how successful this campaign in general is. So again, if Osaka goes well, I expect more and more exhibits going across nationwide, and if they do successfully, I don't see why not that they don't make it worldwide in other parts of the world as well, because I do believe that that was slightly talked about within Club Outside or on Twitter, I'm not quite sure, but again, it has been acknowledged, so that's fantastic, and that's exactly what you want. Because again, and I have to stress this enough, because when I talk about Bleach's future, this is apparent, right? And this is why Bleach came back in the first place. Money talks, and if there is an audience that is willing to throw money at a franchise, chances are Shueisha or TV Tokyo or Period are going to be milking that franchise. Now, of course, you can have good milking and you can have bad milking. So we'll have to see which is the case with Bleach. But as far as this goes, it seems that they want to make the Bleach anime as best as it can because they know how important of a money maker this is. And they know the potential earnings of this, even without it coming out already. And I think they kind of had the same kind of situation with Chainsaw Man as well, seeing how popular that is and seeing how much careful consideration they're doing into that show too. So very excited about that. Club Outside, in speaking of marketing, has been doing so well as well. The fact that it was only supposed to run for 1 year has been upgraded to 2. I know that's kind of old news, but again, as we get closer to the anime as well, we're going to get more stuff on that website too, as well as more Club Outside merchandise as well, which are amazing. None of that Viz Media stuff, but some good quality Bleach goods from over there that are more variety and, you know, a bit more authentic, I guess you could say. Of course, Shueisha has been promoting the Bleach novels a lot on JBook's Twitter account. Now, of course, you can take that either of two ways, but if they're promoting old novels, it would assume that they're getting some sales off it and they're seeing some kind of need and want for it. So, you know, again, with BBS also kind of adapting these novels in that game form as well, getting some voice actors. Again, we spoke about that. Voice actors for not only the Configure Your Own World characters such as Tokinada and Aura, etc., you're now going to have it for Spirits of Forever With You's light novels too. Now, I don't know what they'll do with Spirits of Forever With You. They could do it as OVAs or movies. We don't know. That isn't a part of the question right now, but it seems to me that when the question was posed, too long didn't read situation, Kubo did say he would like to do the Rukia Wedding, which that is way ahead by 3 years of Can't Fear Your Own World. So you need to kind of do Can't Fear Your Own World in order to do We Do Not Always Love You. So again, light novel potential animation is there. Hopefully the Bleach anime in general, Thousand Year Blood War Arc, does fantastic. And if it is, then it kind of validates for them to go further. So very excited for that as well. Burn the Witch is confirmed to be having some news this year, which is very good. We had this confirmed on an email for Club Outside members, where one of the admins did express that we will be getting this news. And I'm very excited for it, whether that's manga or anime. I'm assuming manga. I hope we get a little bit more than 4 chapters. But again, I'm not that stressed. I just need to see Nini back on my screen. I need to read more Burn the Witch. I'm excited for that. And I think, again, perfect timing. When Bleach comes back, you're going to have that promote Burn the Witch alongside it. So again, I'm expecting that around about the summertime, around about the fall time. So excited for that. Even if it's like not coming out this year, at least we'll have news to kind of solidify what is going on with Burn the Witch in general. So a Bleach possible continuation, and I want to make this very brief and short. There was a translated version of the Jump Festival live stream that was recently uploaded. It was a backlog from December, obviously, and something that was very interesting to me, which I feel like I should just briefly touch upon, is the fact that when the Hell chapter was brought up and Morita was talking about, hey, are you bringing it on paperback, or is there going to be more, one of the editors, again I might be wrong, but one of the people in charge did say that there was talks going on about it. Now, of course, this happened with Burn the Witch as well, where people were like, can I have this on paperback? That was then promoted with the Bleach Jet art book, and then again for the Bleach volume for when there was more chapters. And I feel like with this Hell arc, if you are going to release that on paperback, you need something to sell it with. It's not justifiable to sell it as a mini paperback edition, because it might not make that much money, or it might not. Well, I think it will make money, but I don't think, you know, it will validate them to give it out on its own. They probably want to give it out with something. So that's my prediction for that. So if it was going to stay digital, and if it was going to stay as a one shot and nothing more, then the question is that if that's the case, what is there to discuss? If Shueisha are discussing it, what's there to discuss if you were just going to leave it as a digital release or a one shot? There's clearly something to discuss there. And what is that discussion? Well, clearly more than what we got. So with all that being said, that's everything in terms of Bleach's update video for the first 3 months since the Bleach trailer came out. And I'm sure we're going to get a ton more of stuff coming out in the next few weeks or even months. So I will keep you updated on that. Tell me what you guys think in the comment section down below of what you are excited for the most. Please go check out our sponsor. They have been amazing and they've really helped me out this month and the next coming months as well. So please go show some love as well. If you want to send me a picture with the new box, then that'd be amazing as well. But with that being said, I'm going to catch you motherfuckers later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been Hanson, and as always, people, peace out.